This hand looks like almost straight out of modern. Not quite. A little slow. Yeah, I think I'll have to mulligan actually. Very close, especially since he mulliganed. And we do have two bounce lands also. But it's just so slow. I'll keep it. Since he mulliganed, there's a decent chance that he won't be able to cast anything relevant until I have Cryptic Command online. Lands! So many lands. Alright, let's go with Simic Growth Chamber first. Then on turn three, what's my plan? I guess I Trinket Mage. So, Simic Growth Chamber now. Next turn, Island Trinket Mage. With one of these lands in my hand. Yeah, let's have it be. If I choose a floodplain, then it's a tap land, but that gives me my third blue mana source on for turn five. Sacred Foundry would be an untapped land for turn four, so I could Resto, or well, Resto would be the most likely thing. I think I'm gonna go with the Foundry. It's also a red-white source, which is good here. Or no, you know what? I get them all anyways. I figured that was the case. I just didn't realize it. I get them all because I get this free top. Gonna have to discard a card, though. Maybe I should have just left it alone. Well, I guess at this point, repeal is kind of bad. Didn't have a one drop or a two drop. Not repealing that. Yeah! Hope you don't have Dryad Arbor. Okay. Cool. So. Think we're just on top activate floodplain so that we can have Cryptic open ASAP. Let's see. Supreme Verdict. It's probably a good card for us to have access to. And we're not going to attack because our 2/2 is going to draw us another card later on. And his may just die to Resto. Sure. Okay, well, I mean, we're blocking now because we're probably going to have to Supreme Verdict. Actually, did we just Attention Sphere that? No, we're not going to Attention Sphere because of Woodfall Primus. So we're going to Supreme Verdict this sooner or later. Let's just go ahead and tap land go. And then we're gonna take five, we're gonna top, may or may not fetch, probably get a verdict afterwards. Ooh, geez, that's good. I'm actually gonna counter that. Since I have to tap out for this verdict. just going to counter that. I can't actually cast Verdict, can I? Oh, now I can. It misses land wrap. So, wouldn't have to worry about Woodfall Primus yet. I think Verdicting is still correct, though. So let's go ahead and upkeep top, since we're going to shuffle. Consecrated Sphinx and Faith Spiders both seem good here. If I Fetters, I don't have to shuffle. I can just Fetters this Kaiga. Then save the Verdict. I like that, actually. That's probably worse, though. Because now I'm gonna, when I Verdict, my Sphinx is probably gonna be in play. Probably should have just taken the Sphinx and Verdicted. Draw that Verdict, or draw that Sphinx, I mean. Six. I should have actually topped drawn the Delta. No, that's not true. What we have now is fine. So I'm going to leave open Snapcaster Cryptic. I don't want to just put Sphinx into play if I have to Wrath afterwards. Ancient Tomb Go, interesting. He went all the way up to 9 mana and just said go. Do I Revelation or do I just draw go? Draw land go, that is. And of course activate top. I'm gonna top and then draw go. Let's take the Delta. I should have put Steam Augury next, but I'm going to shuffle, so it doesn't really matter. Okay, let's crack some fetch lands. So this is going to be a white source. And we have two red sources. I guess we'll just get an island. Untap. We don't need a top on our upkeep. Okay, Parallax Wave is good here. If we're not gonna have Counterspell mana open. Oh, that's kind of awkward because then he could just Woodfall Primus. Actually, if he Primuses the Wave, though, we could exile all his creatures. No. No, that doesn't work that way. Okay, so we can't really do that. So let's get some cards out of our hand, I suppose. As long as we can keep open 6 mana. 6, 7. Okay, so we have to untap our Steam Vents. And we're going to discard Enlightened Tutor. Since it has exactly 0 targets. Let's see. We're at 8 mana. So we could, we had to get Snapcaster into play or Restoration Angel into play to start attacking. Probably Restoration Angel. Attacks for more. Doesn't get trumped. Okay, cool. We're going to actually counter this. So, very good for us. And we're going to go ahead and draw a card. Yeah. Okay, we're going to upkeep top. Try and find counterspell. Well, we'll take Glacial and we'll keep swords handy. Still kind of awkward for me to put Parallax Wave into play. Let's see. Yeah, I think I'll just cast Kitchen Finks. So if he Primuses, he can blow up the Face Fetters. Then we can... Oh no, it has Persist, huh? Well, I guess we're going to Swords it. Little Shambler. Okay, so he's doing that on a smaller scale. In that case... Well, we're going to let it happen. We're probably going to Wrath. Whether or not we wave before we Wrath, I'm not sure yet. To save our creatures, that is. Interesting. I am a little baffled. He didn't destroy the Faith's Fetters. Okay, in that case... Well, I guess we top first. Counterspell, yay. So we just have to get this off the board. Yeah, we're just going to attack into it and electrolyze. Or... 3-6... Okay, we don't have enough to Sphinx counterspell anymore, so... We could have drawn tops into the land so that we did, but... But this is fine. Well, we should have attacked with Snapcaster. But yeah, we're in fantastic shape, obviously, at this point. Counterspell, Rusto, Blink, Snapcaster, Counterspell. You're at 12. Okay, we'll just electrolyze you now. Colony sounds good. So let's see. Oh, he's in a block. Okay. So you're at 10. Yeah, you're dead. All is dust. Primus, okay. Actually, we didn't even have to counter this, actually. We could have just electrolyzed him. Or no, that would put him at 1. Okay, so we did kind of have to counter this. Or no, he would be dead. No, it's not true. We did have to counter it. He could have blown up either the Faith's Fetters or the Colonnade, so really we just had to counter it. Oh, that was close. Almost didn't activate this. Alright, we're moving on to 2-0 then.